Late Spring Garden Tour, Take Two. Well, it's June 9th today, Sunday morning. There's a start there with the Lily of the Valley. Took a bit of a beating when the sidewalk blocks were lifted. Those three sidewalk blocks were sunken, the ones that Dad put in for me. And they came and drilled holes in them, then forced mud and sand and cement in and lifted them up. So now there's no edge there you can trip on and easier for shoveling in the winter. So, got a nice archway happening there, sadly infested with aphids. And this garden has now been called the survival of the fittest. I gave up the battle on snow in the mountain. It's gonna win. Can see that poor hosta there, days are numbered on that one. And the lilies too, survival of the fittest. My clematis didn't make it over the winter, which I'm really disappointed in. I may replace that. But for the most part, this is just I'll crawl in there for something like a dandelion, but that's about it. Spirea blooming. Got in here yesterday and dug out the grass that was creeping in on my iris collection. Pond hasn't been done this year. I haven't had the time or the energy, neither to clean the riverbed, which still flows there. Mother's Day gift from Marie is that little teacup and saucer bird feeder. I've only ever seen one chickadee there once, and I wasn't fast enough to get a picture of it, so we'll keep an eye on that. There's the strawberries. Had a good result with asparagus this year. My, it was lovely. And that's my rather shabby tunnel to give the tomatoes a bit of a head start. I moved this set of railway ties here, or landscape ties. I'm going to change the size of this garden again, shrinking it again. That's going to all be grass. And there's a planting of garlic and chives at the back. I've got to do this fence this year. Well, I'm hiring someone to repair this fence this year. Paint job, replace some broken pieces. Anyone want a good used picnic table? I'm thinking I need to get rid of that guy. Look at that cranberry, American highbush cranberry, beautiful thing. This bed now is going to be hopefully naturalizing snapdragons over time. Tulips are finished, almost finished. There's one lonely tulip left. I planted a few more snapdragons in there, but the seeds that were dispersed after last year's planting are coming up like mad in there right now, so should be a good showing in the fall. White lilac is finished, but the white roses have taken off. Look at how beautiful they are. Corner. Look at the forget-me-not blooming in there. Isn't that nice? And there's going to be a stand of sunflowers right here where the birds have planted the seeds. Oh, Jane, look, there's a primrose still. A bit of a primrose blossom down in there. It was lovely. Roxanne for that. Look at the ferns. And Blackberry Gate back there. The ferns are almost as tall as these poor cedars. Yep, survival of the fittest now. Hands off. It was the best job I could do in laying out a form and a planting here and letting it go wild. Minimum weeding. There's my beautiful begonia going to blossom there too. Look at that coming through. So that's it, ladies. That's it. Ray's Garden, late spring 2018.